about ready to go into expensive land.
I know, Duesenberg's.
Auburn Park.
It's right in here.
Yep, there they are. Look at that car.
Oh, wow. When we first pull up, you can tell things are different here. There's all kinds of classic Auburns and Cords parked outside the building. But there's even an airplane here. I mean, this is gonna be one of those picks to remember.
Hello.
Come in.
Hey, Doug. Mike, nice to meet you.
Hi, Mike.
Talk to Danny on the phone.
How you doing? Frank, nice to meet you. All right.
I'm Doug Prey. I am the president of the Auburn Cord Duesenberg factory. It's been a family thing since 1960s.
Danny was saying that your father bought the whole contents of the factory out of Indiana?
He did. Glenn Prey, my dad, was a school teacher with no money who bought an automobile factory and moved it to Oklahoma and then started manufacturing Auburns and Cord. He bought it from Dallas Winslow, which is a very rich, famous car builder of the day.
You know what he paid for it back then?
About $80,000.
Yeah. And your dad's a teacher.
Right.
So where did he get that kind of cash?
Well, that's exactly what Dallas Winslow asked me. He said, how are you going to pay for it? He says, well, I'm going to go home and sell some assets. And he's thinking to himself, well, I've got a TV set and I got a Cord, you know.
Yeah.
And then he said, since you're the richest man I've ever met, he said, I thought I'd borrow the rest from you. And the guy liked his guts and his tenacity, and he said, okay.
So your dad was this fearless man.
Glenn Prey was a classic American success story. I mean, this is a guy that punched his own ticket, and he didn't let anyone stand in his way.
Let me show you guys something back here. We have a secret room in this building.
When I hear the word secret room, I get intrigued. I'm thinking like spy novels, Cold War, you know, 007 stuff. But all I'm wondering is, where is he taking us?
This is the secret room.
We walk past this plywood door, and I'm expecting a dungeon.
Okay.
This is not what we expected.
My dad, Glenn, said, I'm going to build an ageless automobile. I'm going to bring back the Cord. He had a full-size drawing of what the car was going to look like on the wall, and he brought his crew in here of 8 guys, and he said, we're going to build that car around that engine on that table. As the word got out that he was building this modern-day version of an original Cord, reporters were coming from all over the country. That door right there opened. Now, I'm a little kid in here, and somebody sneaks his head around the corner, and behind him was a cameraman with his great big camera. And Dad goes over to the door, and he says, you guys have to wait just like everybody else. You can't come in. And he slammed the door in his face. It was Walter Cronkite. And his...
Oh, wow.
My dad told off
Walter. Your dad slammed the door on Walter Cronkite. And your dad was just constantly going for it.
He's like reinventing himself over and over and over.
I know.
Glenn's plan was simple. All he wanted to do was recreate a second generation of these cars with modern technology.
Can I sit in this?
Sure, go right in.
Through the 60s, 70s, and even into the early 80s, Glenn built limited numbers of the cars that he redesigned.
It's a genuine Glenn Prey 874 dual cowl Phaeton.
This is a 1978 version of a reimagined 1936 Auburn.
This is number 17 of 17 built. Got a patent on the design.
Lincoln 460 big block.
It's got air conditioning in it.
And automatic transmission. Bam!
Why does it have the gauges in the back here to let the passenger know what the RPMs, how fast you're going?
Well, it'd be typically back in the 30s, we're in a chauffeur-driven car.
Okay.
So the little rich lady sitting in the back seat is back seat driving, telling the chauffeur to slow down.
Slow down, you're up
to 40. That's where back seat driving came from.
Oh, okay.
I love today.
Hey, man. Thank you so much.
Thank you, appreciate
Frank?
It. Thanks for letting us look through your stuff.
Good luck with everything.
Oh, thank you.
All right.
A lot of fun. Dad would have had a lot of fun dickering back and forth, telling stories. He loved to buy and sell. He loved the art of the deal. And Mike and Frank are good at that.
See you, Doug.
Hey, bye, guys.
Take care.
See ya.
Glenn Prey didn't just save a bunch of parts from the scrap heap. This is a guy that took one of the great American automobile companies and moved it forward.
It's like a day-to-day treasure hunt. I'm out there looking for rusty gold. I'm looking for the unusual and impossible.
It's back roads, it's dumpster diving, it's flea markets, it's people's homes.